Augusta Mudhikani will be our first presenter. Please put your hands together as you welcome Augusta Mudhikani.
Thank you. My presentation is on values development in teacher training needs, implications for lecturers and teacher primary teacher training colleges in Kenya. And that is the outline of what I'll cover within 10 minutes. Now, teachers have a great opportunity to facilitate values development in learners, as we have heard from the previous speaker. Teachers are a critical resource in facilitating values development at all levels. Therefore, teachers engage in values development consciously and unconsciously. However, the preparedness of teacher educators in primary teacher training colleges in the critical role of enabling values development is not clear. And what I mean by preparedness, the teacher educators in Kenyan primary teacher training colleges usually have a background in education, but no preparedness in facilitating primary teacher education. This paper, therefore, is motivated by the belief that lecturers in primary teacher training colleges hold an advantaged position and are able to influence teacher trainees positively through teaching and learning processes, thus enabling them to construct values that would impact in their lives. Teachers have great opportunity to facilitate values. And development of values through education enables individuals to acquire values and have access to and succeed in life. Now, quality training has a component of values development and is concerned with the transfers of skills, knowledge, and behavior and attitude in order to have competent citizens. The process of transferring values from the lecturer to the teacher trainee is unclear. Now, values development and forming in character is the second of all the education important goals. Teaching is about moral character, ethical decisions, and values. And according to Kaur and Nagel, a teacher is expected to function not only as a facilitator for acquisition of knowledge, but also as an inculcator of values and transformer of inner being. Now, Lampkin suggests that during interaction with students, teachers are expected to display behaviors reflective of moral virtues, such as fairness, honesty, and adhere to professional code of conduct. Actually, in Kenya, the teacher's code of conduct has a very heavy component on values that teachers ought to display. It may be argued that teachers, educators then, should facilitate values development with means intentionally. So it has to be purposeful if we are going to ensure that teachers who graduate from primary teacher training colleges are acquainted with values education, then the teacher educators have to be purposeful in facilitating that. Studies indicate that there's a gap between education policymakers' intentions and teachers' understanding in the implementation of values in education. However, some teacher educators are limited in skills and knowledge of modeling the values. Rationale for values education in primary teacher training colleges. Education is about knowledge, skills, attitude, and flourishing of humanity. And humanity can only flourish where there are values. Education is values infused. And these values help a person to grow in all areas, that is intellectually, emotionally, socially, and spiritually. Values entail all kinds of activities in schools through which learners implicitly or explicitly learn or develop values and morality. Therefore, pre-service teacher education programs are meant to prepare teachers to become quality teachers equipped with pedagogical practices that will meet the increasing demands associated with the teaching profession. And one of the demands is to ensure that the persons who graduate through the education system have certain values. Why are values important at the teacher training level? They are important because teachers, due to their pivotal role, have an opportunity to help learners acquire skills that will make them choose certain values. Education is expected to function not only as a facilitator of acquisition knowledge, but also as a transformer of the inner person. Values education is also important at the teacher training level because it helps the teachers who graduate help pupils to relate values to corresponding actions in their life based on informed and discerned positions. Consequently, teacher educators have to be purposeful, as I mentioned earlier, and intentional in facilitating development of values. The role of teacher educators is critical. I think I've talked about that. And this implies that if teacher educators have a foundation in values-focused curriculum, then there's a possibility that teacher trainees will acquire specific values and transfer the same to teacher trainees. However, if the teacher educators in a primary teacher training college are not clear about the values and do not have the skills to pass the same values to the trainee, there may be a possibility of facilitating unintentionally the trainees to unlearn values that they may have acquired before. Lecturers in Kenya constitute the core of education system, and their importance in education performance has been widely confirmed by many studies. However, there is limited literature exploring the preparation of lecturers in facilitating values development in teachers' trainees, as stated by Wamahi. The primary teacher education curriculum has explicit values that teacher educators, that is lecturers, are expected to facilitate trainees to acquire. The objectives of the same are clear, that trainees are being prepared to develop values that focuses on morals, religious values, citizenship, national attitude, so that by the time they leave, they graduate, they are able to impart the same in trainees. However, teacher education in Kenya, as has been alluded by the previous speaker, focuses on academic achievement only, at the expense of the formation of an integrated person. Academic focus and lack of emphasis at that level is not only a problem in Kenya, it's quite wide. Few of the teacher trainers have primary education training experience and training in adult education. And this may make it actually be a challenge for them to transfer values to trainees who do the same to trainers, to teach to pupils. There is no induction programs for teacher trainers for primary teacher training colleges at Kenya. The PT curriculum seems unclear on how the values are to be acquired and transferred both at the teacher, trainee, and at the pupil level. Yet the lecturers are expected to prepare the trainees to develop values based on their objective. Literature exploring the extent to which values are developed during the pre-service teacher training is limited. In addition, teacher training colleges have also faced with lack of understanding on the importance of values in teacher education, lack of capacity building to enable lecturers teacher educators acquire skills and knowledge and language that facilitates values development, and uncertainty on what values to focus on from the curriculum and how to integrate the same in the teaching and learning process. As stated earlier, the teacher training objective focuses on academic achievement, thus adequate time is allocated to values development. And this has implications on the effectiveness of teacher educators in facilitating values development. So the question remains as to the preparedness of the teacher educators, the primary teacher training level, and the skills that they have in order to integrate values that are in the primary teacher training curriculum, namely respect, care, empathy, tolerance, and cooperation in their day-to-day teaching. As values-based teacher educators curriculum, a value-based teacher educators curriculum will strengthen provision of teacher education in primary teacher training by laying a base for the review and identification and preparation of lecturers. Issues of lecturers' preparedness in facilitating values development remains very elusive. In facilitating values education is important to further the values agenda in education. Whereas the need has been stated in numerous studies, the preparation for lecturers at that level for the same needs to be developed. Lecturers need skills in teaching approach so that they are able to have the competences to pass the same to the trainees. Furthermore, a part of preparation of the lecturers need to be encouraged to appreciate that the values they hold determine their actions in and out of class and determine how they model the same to their students. Without skills and knowledge on values, it will be very difficult for lecturers to model specific values outlined in the primary teacher education curriculum. Therefore, continuous professional development for the teacher educators may reflect on values as well as pedagogies that facilitate the same. And this is important because of the evolving needs in the society. And the issues of lecturer preparation for the lecturers that work in teacher primary colleges in these countries remain elusive and is very
Agosta for further stimulating this discussion on values.